This video will explain how to calculate hydraulic gradient and velocity of water flow using floor nets. Let's look at these examples that we have here. We have two different water levels. The one on the left is higher than the one on the right. And we have water seepage underneath these sheet piles. And there is a point B somewhere here. And we need to calculate the hydraulic gradient at point B and the velocity of flow at point B. To start with, we would just find H, the difference in water levels, that will cause water seepage underneath this engineering structure. And as I told you before, we need to look for two water levels. So level 1 and level 2, and the difference between these two water levels will give us H. In this case, is going to be 8 meters. So next step that we need to do is to count of number of equipotential drops. So we will start here, because the seepage starts from this point, and then we finish here. So typically we'll just choose a flow channel somewhere in the middle. So I'm going to choose this one. We count number of drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, because point B is in this channel, in the channel below, let's also count the number of drops there. It should be also 8. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So number of drops, it's 8. And now we need to find the total head loss for each equipotential drop. And we use delta H for this. So it's equal H divided by number of drops, which is 8 divided by 8, it's equal to 1 meter. So this means for each equipotential drop, when water flows through each drop, is going to lose 1 meter of total head. Okay, so now let's find the hydraulic gradient for point B. And what we need to know is delta H and L, because the definition of hydraulic gradient is delta H divided by L. So in this case, we would see that water would flow in this direction, and then it starts from this equipotential line and goes all the way to this line. So we need to know this distance. So this is going to be our first point here and second point here. It doesn't matter that point B is in the middle of the drop, or it can be like somewhere inside the drop. We still need to know these two points, where it starts and where it finishes, because we know delta H for each drop. So we know that delta H, it will be 1 meter. So we already found this one. So in this case, we're going to write delta H divided by L. Delta H is 1 meter, and the distance between these two equipotential lines is given to us as 5 meters, so it will be 0.2. So hydraulic gradient for point B will be 0.2. Now we're going to find the velocity. And to find the velocity, we're going to use this formula, which is k times I. And the coefficient of permeability is provided. So in this case, we can rewrite that velocity is equal 1.6 times 10 to the power of negative 6 multiplied by 0.2, and will give us 0.32 times 10 to the power of negative 6 meters per second. Thanks.